welcome to Tech Tips for this week. For those that don't know me, my name is Marty, and I'm the in-house tech support for the Lifestyle Business Builders, soon to be Lifestyle Entrepreneurs Academy. We're having a big rebrand very soon, and it's very exciting. And I'm sure some of you watching this will be there. So this week, I just wanted to give you a really quick tech tip on what is one of the most crucial parts of building your business is the design and the branding that goes with it. Now, it can be a really great thing to have beautiful branding and design, but it can be very expensive. And for that purpose, one of our favorite tools, and everyone I know's favorite tools, is Canva. Now, Canva is a really simple graphic design tool, and I'm just gonna share my screen with you. So you can create Facebook posts, you can create your, like I've done like four now logos. I do all my website design, anything that I'm creating, I pop in here. And it's just a really easy to use tool. Now, when I say easy to use, it's not always so easy. There's some hints and tips and tricks and all sorts of stuff that you can actually spend hours, and you can go down what we like to lovingly refer as the Canva rabbit hole. And you can actually spend days on here having fun tinkering with things. But in case you don't know, which I didn't really realize, up the top, so I'm just in my Canva account, I'm at the home screen. Up here, they've got Learn. If you click on Learn, they actually have a full design school that you can access for free. So the beauty is, I've been through it, not all of it, because there is quite a lot in here, but just to go through to get the basics, to save you kind of just sort of moving the pieces and not actually getting design done. It's also good because these are designers that actually go through this stuff. Now, design is a very finicky thing. If you get it wrong, it can really sort of damage the brand. Like if you really have the elements not right and it just doesn't fit your personality, it can really sort of jar people, and it'll build less rapport. So if you think of design like a rapport builder, it's actually helping you connect with your clients or potential clients. So in here, they've got Canva for beginners. You just start the course and get stuck in. Then you've got, like, you know, if you're needing to do presentations, get some help with that. If you want some graphic design basics, like knowing that, you know, if the image should be round or square, or what kind of, you know, you don't want to be crowded, how much white space there should be, how the fonts should match, all that kind of stuff. Really great thing to do. Social media mastery. Where would we be without socials? So, you know, just spending that time to learn some basics can really revive your brand and make it stand out from the crowd and make you look more professional, which therefore means credible. Personal branding, like there's even more in here. Canva to the classroom, branding your business, become a Pinterest creator. Down here, there's getting started designing. There's like 54 videos in here. A lot of them will be really short and quick, so it's not like you have to spend days doing it. If you're in the education, which could be helpful for you, doing your branding. And then they even have events where you can actually go to live events on Canva. So this is something that's kind of overlooked in Canva. I didn't even realize it was there. And then when I saw it, I was like, oh my God, this is incredible. I'd done the basic tutorials, but I didn't realize there was this whole design school here ready and waiting for you to get your branding looking more professional and really helping you engage with your clients. So that is my top tip for today. I hope that's useful. Give yourself a limit when you go into Canva. Say, I'm just going to be here for an hour, because otherwise you can actually spend so much time in Canva playing. And it's one of those business things that most of us find is fun. So, you know, when you're needing a bit of a pick-me-up, spend like a half an hour in Canva, and, you know, get some funky images going and start sharing them on your socials and just see what kind of response you get. Sometimes, you know, it'll be flat. Sometimes you might get a lot more engagement just because you've upped your game. So that's my top tip. That's my tech tip for this week. And I'll be back next week. I'll see you then. Bye for now.